Good morning, back now with Today Property Watch. The property market typically goes a bit cool during winter, but new data out today shows vendors are willing to defy this trend this season.
So, should you sell your home now or hold off? To discuss, we're joined by Domain property editor Alice Stoltz in Melbourne. Good morning to you, Alice. So, what can we expect in the property market this winter?
Good morning, guys. Well, yeah, we've certainly been through a period of 12 months of really choppy and uncertain times. But despite this, we actually are seeing prices rise. And we are also seeing, most importantly, properties selling. You can see the latest clearance rates up on the screen now are really quite strong, particularly in our most auction-centric markets of Sydney and Melbourne. They're the highest that they've been since this time last year. So this winter is going to offer a more realistic market. And I think we've got many vendors who have really adjusted to the climate that we're in. They know we're in interest rate rising cycle, and they are willing to negotiate a lot more, which is going to be good news for buyers.
Okay, so what are the pros and cons of buying? Because as you say, many people are apprehensive about selling at this time of year.
Yeah, look, I'll give you two little secrets. This is certainly the time when real estate agents themselves sell. And as a reason for that, there is just so much less competition in the market in the winter months. So I think if you are going to be selling in winter, you need to think about the way you're sort of marketing your house out in market. So I would really encourage to sort of lean into that winter theme and do lots of cozy styling, have those heaters on, know that the garden's going to be a bit sort of bare, so potentially have lots of lovely indoor plants and flowers, and really, I guess, embrace the fact that you're selling a house in winter. It won't look perhaps as lovely as it will in summer, but try to entice a buyer into thinking, if it looks this good now, imagine how it could look when spring rolls around or in the summer months of December and January.
Okay, so let's have a look at how the market is doing now. How were clearance rates last weekend?
Clearance rates were very strong last weekend. Adelaide 83, Sydney 81%. Now, I wonder if this was because of that rate rise in June and the RBA signifying there are going to be more rates to come, if those with pre-approved finance did want to kind of get out there before there are further rate increases potentially. But stock levels today, when we're looking at what's happening around the country, you can see that in Melbourne, stock levels are down a little bit today, 625, 583 in Sydney. And Melbourne and Sydney are now, Melbourne and Queensland are now entering school holiday period. So we will see a bit of a lull over the next couple of weeks, knowing that we are going to school holidays all around the country in the weeks to come.
Alice, the most expensive home to sell this week, where was it?
Guys, it was an incredible apartment in Pyrmont in Sydney. It sold for $8.25 million. Three bedroom, three bathroom. It has a private and direct lift straight to that penthouse location and 315 square metres of outdoor living with those incredible views all around that beautiful harbour part of Sydney. Our most affordable apartment sale was a two bedroom apartment in Cairns. Two bedroom, one bath, sold for $250,000 just minutes from the Cairns CBD.
Ooh,
and a pool
nice.
On site as well.
That's great. Okay, tell us about some of the more unique properties.
We have a really spectacular home in Yamba on the market today. Now, this is in the price range of $14 million. And this house has all those latest luxe additions. Obviously, a pool and spa, of course. Two-hole golf course, half basketball court, sauna. It's got an outdoor bathtub for ice baths, which we're seeing a lot more of this trend in houses now, as well as a boat cleaning bay, which is obviously what every house needs, and a fish cleaning bench with sinks. So whatever you catch on that boat, you can clean before you bring it into that amazing house. Now we're going to go over to Bedford Dale in Perth now. This amazing house, again in Perth. We saw a beautiful one there last week. On the market though, between $12 and $15 million, four bedroom, four bath. Now this is a beautiful sort of Japanese architecture on this home. And what's incredible about it, it's won a lot of awards, this home, but it's on a huge land parcel. But I think it's just the sort of, these beautiful Japanese inspired gardens are quite spectacular. And apparently the agent told me they're having a lot of interest from interstate buyers for what is clearly an exceptional property. Finally, we're going over to Mount Buller in Victoria now. If you're a lover of ski fields, this is a beautiful chalet on the market, $9.75 million. And we know that many people who can afford it love that idea of having that sort of ski in, ski out location that they can enjoy in winter for skiing and potentially beautiful summer hiking. But it's a pretty incredible property, but again, with a pretty incredible price tag to go with it.
Perfect place for après ski.
Yeah, I like that, Clint.
All right, Alice, thanks so much.
thank you so much for your company on this Saturday morning. If your supermarket shop is well and truly eating into your weekly budget, you're probably not alone.
No, new data shows that one third of Aussies say the rising cost of groceries is their biggest financial burden.
But there are some clever ways to make your cash go a little bit further. To tell us more, we're joined by Compare the Market spokesperson Chris Ford in Brisbane. Chris, good morning. Firstly, how much is the average Aussie actually spending at the checkout each week?
Yeah, good morning, guys. Look, it is startling research. We've all seen it. When we go to the shop each week, those little bits and bobs all seem to just be getting more and more expensive. Well, this research found the average Aussie household is spending $199 a week. That is the average. That is more than $10,000 over the course of the year. So, yes, a really stressful time for Aussie households that are already feeling that cost of living pinch.
When you say $10,000 over the course of a year, it really does hit home. How does it compare to previous years?
Well, look, it has increased. I mean, we looked back at the same research conducted just 2 years ago, more than $1,500 when it comes to an annual increase, $169 to $199 now. So that $30 increase, it increased again last year. And this is why we are feeling the pinch when it comes to, you know, mortgage repayments increasing or rent increasing, insurance premiums increasing, energy bills increasing. So a really difficult time.
Even when you nick in to grab a couple of things, that basket, you know, you go to the checkout, it's $70, $80, $90, isn't it? Who's feeling the grocery pinch most?
Well, look, in terms of who was most stressed, it was actually Gen Z, the younger generation. And look, this can make sense. Most likely casual jobs or studying and the like. They're actually the ones also spending the least, maybe just filling the basket with a few two-minute noodles there. When it comes to the ones who are spending the most, it is Gen X. Again, logical. There could be the ones with families, young children. And perhaps interestingly, baby boomers were the least stressed when it came down to cutting costs at the supermarket.
OK, well, what are some clever ways that we can all reduce our grocery bills?
Yeah, well, look, I've cut it down into two options, before you get to the supermarket and then while you're at the supermarket. So first of all, consider any existing insurance policies. You have energy plans, mobile phone plans. Some do come with a discount. Say Woolworths, their everyday insurance product offers 10% off a shop once a month, and that can be a significant way to save. So do that research ahead of time. Also do your research for the products you're after. Don't necessarily be loyal to those big supermarkets. Check if there are equivalent products at cheaper prices elsewhere. Then when you're at the supermarket, look at those unit prices. There's a saying that eye line is buy line. So look above and below and you might be able to find cheaper prices, you know, sort of at knee level and that cheaper unit price. And then when you're at the checkout, make sure you're flashing those reward cards, boosting those points. Some will enable a voucher to be used in future shops.
Some good tips there for us. Thanks so much, Chris Ford.
Thanks, guys.